So if you meet and marry a woman who was living in inhospitable conditions in a third world country and you bring her to America, how do you know if she is with you because she wants to be with you and not because she just wants to get away from those horrible conditions?
All right, so I know this guy who went overseas. He went to another country to meet a woman. I guess he met her online. He met her overseas. They developed this relationship, and he brought her back to America. He married her, brought her back to America, and married her. So how many guys are going overseas, going to other countries to find love, to find marriage, to find a wife? Hey guys, welcome back to the Dimcad channel. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. I know somebody actually went overseas. I think he went to, I don't know if it was Colombia or maybe it was Venezuela. It's one of those countries in either South America or Central America. I think it's Central America. He met her online. He flew down there, and he actually flew down there several times to meet this woman. And he found himself a woman he can really connect with. He cited some of the reasons why he went to that part of the world. This was an American guy, a white guy. He cited some of the reasons why he did it is because he felt like a lot of the women in that part of the world were more accommodating. They were just friendlier, they're more respectful. He thought that they were less materialistic than the women that he encountered here in America. He thought they were more family-oriented and things like that. And a lot of guys go to Central America, South America, to find a wife that has those values, to find a woman that has those values. I thought it was really interesting. I'm not willing to go to another country to find a wife. That's just me, you know. But I'm glad that he was able to find somebody that he was able to connect with. And I was wondering if you guys would ever consider doing something like that, because a lot of American men do complain about American women. And for me, I've never even left the country, which is sad and pathetic. I plan on changing that. Hopefully within the next year or so. I'm definitely going to change it within the next year or so. I'm thinking about going to Hong Kong or Tokyo. Those are high on my list. I just want to experience another culture. I like the idea of possibly dating somebody from another culture. That's something that's pretty cool too. Somebody from another country, and maybe even just somebody from a different ethnic group, you know, Latina, or somebody, you know, it could be a Mexican-American, a Colombian-American, you know, just Puerto Rican-American. I like the idea of really just interacting with different people from different parts of the world, people from different experiences, people with different experiences. That appeals to me because I don't see the point of just looking for somebody who's exactly like me in every way. We got to share some values. I would need a woman who supports the Second Amendment, obviously, but beyond that, anyway. A lot of you guys, do you know anybody who's actually done that? I know when I was in Michigan, I knew this one guy who actually had a woman from Russia. He actually got, she was this Russian woman in Flint, Michigan, you know, living with this guy. He's a white guy and an older guy, and she was a little bit younger than he was, and I thought that was an interesting dynamic. I'm not willing to go to another country to look for a wife or anything, and I don't know if I would really have enough in common with a woman from a different country. I mean, I want to have something in common, you know, something in common, but again, I haven't left the country, so I can't really say that for sure. I don't know. You know, that's why new experiences are so important. You learn about things. So what do you guys think? Here's my concern. Here's what one of my concerns. You know how people go from one location to another and they don't really change? They bring their values and their belief systems they had in one location, they bring it to the second location, and they try to change the second location. Okay, I'm talking about California. Californians who moved to Texas and want gun control. But, you know, well, somebody moves from, I don't know, Brazil or someplace like that, or Chile, or whatever, South America, somewhere in South America or Central America, and they come to America and they change because they're in a whole other environment. You know, a lot of guys complain about a lot of American women and how they're materialistic, apparently. And I mean, I like material things too. I'm not gonna lie. But anyway, a lot of guys complain about that. But when, if you get a woman from South America with values that you like, but then you bring her to America, and she's around all these American women, and she becomes an American woman. Her values change. Her, you know, the woman you thought you married becomes somebody different. Because I've seen a lot of guys who married American women who thought, you know, guys got married in general who thought they're marrying one type of woman, but then when they got married and the kids came along, then they ended up with something entirely different. But it wasn't all the woman's fault too. But anyway, I'm not gonna get into that. But a lot of guys have complained about that. So would you be concerned about that? You know? So anyway, guys, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.